within the parameters of what's safe and what's smart for every single American.
Congressman, this is Megan. You are 72 years old and you are a type 2 diabetic. So that puts you in a category of those who are particularly vulnerable to this virus. Can you walk us through your symptoms, how sick you were, and how quickly did this disease come on to you?
Yeah, you know, Megan, that's really a good point because I thought at first I just had some strain of the flu. I didn't really recognize it as something that I hadn't had before. My wife, though, was very, very aware of it. She says, you know what? I mean, you're sleeping with two blankets on. You're still cold. You're not eating. You have no sense of taste. And when you sleep, you're sleeping like 16 to 18 hours a day and you're still tired. Now, you know, fortunately, I didn't have the respiratory problem. But I got to my doctor, Dr. DiCuccio at the Butler in Butler here. He very quickly got me tested. I went into the Butler Hospital, the drive-through, got tested. Within 24 hours, they told me, listen, you have the virus, so what we want you to do is stay home, and we'll prescribe stuff. So Z-Pak, which most people use, and then the hydrochloroquine, I took it. So maybe that reduced the effects on me, but I didn't have the respiratory part, which is a real blessing.
Did you just say that you took the hydrochloroquine? I'm not, my sound
yes,
is
ma'am.
A little weird.
Yes, I took it.
Wow. I can't believe anybody with a brain would take that stuff, but you seem like an intelligent guy. You're a representative in Congress.
Yeah.
Why would you take that drug? There are terrible consequences.
Yeah, well, I appreciate that's your view. That's not my view, and we're on the view, but let me just say this to you. In my case,
right.
I can't say definitively that that's what cured me, but I can say definitively that I took it, and I can say that I went through a period of time that I was sick. I came out of it within about 9 days, and then I self-quarantined for another month on top of that. So if you stay within the parameters of what's the guidance, and if you're smart about what you do, you stay safe, you keep other people safe by staying away from them, I don't think there's anything stupid about that. I still think I'm a relatively pretty intelligent guy, but I don't tell anybody there's a one size fits all. I say, go to the doctors that you have faith in, listen to what they say. If your doctor says, don't take it, then don't take it. My doctor thought, you know what? We have something that we think could possibly work,
alert from
and
Canada,
we're going to give it to you.
PA delegation member and staff call WPA Secretary of Health.
Getting all kinds of strange things in my